Hello, everybody, and welcome back to more XCOM 2 Long War 2. I'm Liz. We're on the Avenger, as we almost always are at the start of these videos. I rarely start them in a mission. We've got some stuff going on. We're clearing machinery. We've got power coil coming in. Stun Lancer is going to be done right away. I just spent all of my money, so I'm not going to be able to buy a melee weapon. Maybe we get a prototype. I doubt we get a prototype. Maybe we get a prototype. Oh, right. We're doing an Intel scan site. 47 Intel. Awesome. That's really good. I think we're going to make contact with West Asia. But this is vulnerable. We got a lot of time left on that. Let's make contact with West Asia. Yep.
Setting course for Sector 15, West Asia.
Let's do it.
Attempting to establish.
I have made a number of interesting discoveries, Commander.
Awesome.
Advent clearly intended for these units to be their means of dealing with any unruly civilians within the city centers. It seems they have come to rely on more brutal means of pacification in the time since.
Thank you, Tegan. Okay, so we've got new item available, the Arc Blade, the Ionic Axe, and the Advanced Arc Thrower. I am not going to be able to build any of these right now. That looks awesome. And the Arc Blade, yes. Okay, so the next research is probably Advent Office or Autopsy. Unless I desperately need Illyrium, in which case it's rendering a core. I would like advanced laser weapons. That's 10 crystals. I would have 10 crystals if I rendered a core. But, I don't know. Advent Robotics is really good. It gives us access to the Gremlin Mark II. We don't need it yet. Not going to use time on basic research and engineering research right now, but we might in the future. Yeah, I think we just do the officer autopsy now, guys. It's 9 days.
The officers appear to be similar, if not.
Okay.
I've started to.
That should go relatively quickly.
Use our current band of renegades.
6 days till a supply drop. We should have this territory before that. Guerrilla ops. Moderate heavy. 5 days. It reduces enemy strength. It's ambush and advent troop column, which means there's not going to be a time limit on it. It's just a straight up fight them mission. And it's 5 days expiration. I am feeling like I want to do this.
Setting course for East Asia.
It reduces advent strength in the region, so we're going to send a squad. We're going to send an awesome squad. Like Haas. Who else? Who's going with Haas? I can't believe Catley Khan is one of my highest ranking people now. Flipper. Haas, Flipper. Butcher. Yeah. You're in. Big money. We've got big money and DEF CON. Both are 16 movement. DEF CON has more health. Even if lower aim, but you're a grenadier, so yeah, DEFCON, you're in. That's 3 days, 7 hours. We have just under 5 days available on this one. I might try and swing some suppressors on it. I'm probably going to make some weapons available and equip this squad with them, even though I don't usually like doing that, just because I want the best for this mission. We're gonna bring a gunner. We've got Giggles. Let's bring Giggles. And I'd like a sixth. If I can get a sixth, then I can get some suppressors on people, then that would be great. A sharpshooter, right? Yeah, we want a sharpshooter, I think. So the cleaner? She's got 85 aim. Like, come the fuck on. Alright, I'm gonna gear these people up, and we're gonna see where we stand. I'll probably... Even though I rarely do, I'm probably going to make some items available and see if I can get these guys kitted out with the best that we have to offer. I'll see you in a bit. Alright, here's our squad. We don't have a specialist in this squad. We're bringing medkits on the assault and the sharpshooter. I'm bringing the hazmat vest on the ranger. Since you're not bringing a medkit, that will give you the poison immunity. The shinobi is going to bring the crit reduction vest. The other two must be in use in the other infiltration because they are not available. We have laser weapons. Absolutely max kitted out laser weapon on our ranger here, Haas. We've got suppressors on everything except for the shinobi's weapon, which is the least needed suppressor, although it always helps a little bit. And that got our infiltration down to under the mission expiration. So we're in good shape. We have an extra squad member, and we still only have plus 1 day on here, so it's not bad. Not bad at all. Minus 9 hours for abilities and gear modifier. I like it. We are going to bring the Shadowkeeper along because it does have additional aim and crit bonuses. So it's good. Still not a guaranteed kill. And the laser pistol was not available, so that's the main reason. Just the one flashbang on the gunner. Although we're bringing the frost bomb. And that's going to be it. So let's start this infiltration. We should be able to finish the infiltration no problem. Even with only 4 days, and that's going to be a good mission to complete. This one still has lots of time. 4 days. They are very vulnerable. Light activity, so that's good. I want to make contact, though, because I want to get this done before the supply drop. Recovered from wounds. Awesome. For fuck's sake. 4 days, 3 hours. Liberation. Rescue a defector. Engineer. Baseline activity is heavy. 4 days, 3 hours. I'm going to skip that one. Another gorilla op. 6 days, 1 hour. Extract VIP from Advent City. Free an important prisoner. Extremely light. We're going to go do this one. I'm going to make contact first, though. We've seen that cutscene. Awesome. So we have a new area. We have access to Eastern Europe, but we don't have a tower, so it's going to cost us a lot. Yeah, it'd cost us a lot more intel to go that way. I think it's still cheap to go to Western USA, though, right? So that could be a possibility. What do we have here? 5 people. Not bad. Supply. Recruit. Intel. We are going to stick 1 person on recruiting here and 1 person on supply because I want to. We're probably going to give them an advisor right away as well. Who do I want to give as an advisor, though? I have 2 technicals tied up as advisors already. I mean, technicals are great, but they're not that useful to me when they're tied up as advisors. I might have 1 too many rangers. I could probably assign 1 of them there. But I really don't want to because they're awesome. I could give them an engineer or a scientist. That'd be good in the long run. But for now, yeah, no, I'm not going to assign an advisor there just yet. Advent strength is 1, which is exceptionally good. We're going to go do this infiltration real quick. Yeah.
Setting course for the Arctic.
It's going to be 5 days by the time we get there. But I don't need a huge squad for this one, I don't think. Extremely light baseline. We have 5 days, 13 hours. Yeah, we're fine with this one. Let's, do we send Liu? Dinger? Or do we send somebody a little bit greener? Like Sydney Hawkins? Or Kimura Nobu? Let's send Sydney. Along with a shinobi, Dieter, as always. Do we have an assault who's not crashed? 14 movement, an assault, maybe more movement, but lower level? No. Chops, but Chops is already infiltrating and has less movement, in fact. Okay, that's fine. We'll just send Crash. Grenadier might be nice. This is an extraction, so that's a thing. I have Warhorse, Rodriguez. Well, Big Money and Warhorse are the same level, basically, so, and they both have 16 movement. I'm gonna bring Warhorse, because I can. Alright, so that's 4 days, 3 hours. We could probably get one more person in here, okay. What are we missing? We could use a gunner or a sharpshooter. A little bit of firepower of some sort. Or a specialist even. Combat protocol is pretty good. Have a couple corporals. Do I have a lance corporal specialist? No, that's a squaddy. Ooh. Well, I have to get you combat protocol somehow, right? So I guess we bring you along. So this is going to be a bit of a training day mission as well, but it should be okay. I'm going to equip these people. I'll be right back. One thing that I forgot to do in the previous infiltration, I gave the Ranger Predator armor, but I didn't give anybody else in the mission Predator armor, and I had three more available. Should have given to the Shinobi and the Assault at least, as well as the Ranger. Oh well, I guess we do it here. Predator armor. I'll see you soon. Okay, we've got a laser rifle with some mods on it. Not the best mods, but a couple of them. Also bringing a medkit on the Assault, as well as a medkit on the Specialist. Specialist with the gas mask, because why not? Flashbang grenade on our Grenadier, as well as on our Shinobi, because we have nothing better to bring on the Shinobi. We have no special rounds or anything like that, so we're bringing a lot of miscellaneous grenades and whatnot that we don't necessarily need to, but whatevs. And I think that is going to be our infiltration for this mission. Three Predator armors, so we're going to have lots of beefy HP. I really wish I had put all four Predator armors on the tough mission, or at the very least the three main upfront soldiers. Let's start that. Start infiltration. Okay, so we are definitely in a good position to do this mission now. It's at 155%. It is recover item from Advent Train with 31 intel rewards, so lots of intel. It counters major breakthrough, which is huge for us right now. They are vulnerable. We could still do 2 days, but it doesn't matter. Light activity. Let's do this one. This is not the big, crazy, everybody, like, all hands on deck mission, but this is a significant one. We've got some seriously good soldiers assigned to this one, too. And a lot, I think. I think, didn't we send 7 soldiers on this mission? I might be totally wrong. I might be thinking about a different one, but I don't know. We'll see. I want to see the infiltration screen. I'm curious who I sent on it now. This would have been in the last session that I set this infiltration up. Come the fuck on, XCOM. Seriously? Okay, here we go. So we have a laser weapon on it, so that's good. Alright, I'll see you when we get in the mission.
Menace 1-5, we've got a bead on the Advent Data Vault near your position. Be advised, self-detonating charges are in place at the target. Move to disarm and extract the package before its contents are destroyed.
Okay. We can move up here and we can go along the train lengths. Might be good. I mean, I could go on the other side of the train, right? Like, the train is next to the zone map. The zone map's... or the map, limit is right here. You can see the red lines. So if I move on this side of the train, I'll have relative safety, I suppose. There's a lot of space. Well, this is next to the map limits as well. We can move up through this town area and then move into the train later. I think what we're going to try and do is maybe move right and go up this way. I've been experimenting with different encoding techniques. This video I'm finishing with this method, but a future video I might switch to a different encoding method. Let's go all the way, like hardcore dash into here. We've got directional cover. We should not be revealed unless there's somebody standing right here. Yeah, so we're okay there. No aliens at all, in fact, in sight.
Roger that.
So let's start moving our peeps over.
Already there.
Enrique, you don't actually have a whole lot of movement.
Let's do this.
And this first turn is dashes. It's dashes all day, day. Whiskey, James Roberts. Let's move up to here. What I don't want is for a patrol to lock us in. So I don't want anybody so far up close to an enemy that a patrol would lock us in our position. Because that would suck. Then we would absolutely have to engage. Currently, though, we can take as many turns maneuvering as we want because we have true concealment, as I mention every fucking time.
They keep these trains running around the clock, but you'll never see them loading or unloading any cargo. At least not where anyone can see it.
Thank you, Bradford. That was interesting. Was that a mech? I don't know. I'm not as good with sound cues in XCOM 2 yet as I am in the first XCOM. I've only played XCOM 2 through vanilla and with minor mods a couple of times. It's not like, you know, the dozens of times I've played XCOM. Enemy unknown / enemy within, you know. You get what I mean. Alright. Shinobi. I mean, most of the map is this direction. Not a lot of it is this way. I feel... And you know what? There's high cover that would block line of sight from this way, so yeah, I feel like we're not going to reveal ourselves by moving here. We don't spot anything. I can move all the way up to here, but that's dangerous from this direction. It might be better moving like here, or here, where we're in cover from that side, but then we can be seen through here. This is a little more dangerous. It might be best actually just to move up to here this turn.
Position confirmed.
Again, we don't have to rush anything. We are concealed still.
Solid copy.
Let's try and get the whole team up into this general area.
Let's do this.
Might take a couple of turns. Oh, well, no, Enrique can get up to here, so that's pretty good.
There.
The assault might be a little bit behind. Because the assault... Oh, you could get pretty far up there, too. It's almost better for you to move up to here. Is there anything? Well, there's a house this way, but... If it was that wide open alley, I'd be more concerned, but I think I'll do that. Yeah, the assault has pretty piss-poor movement. But we're gonna move you up to here.
Go.
Get you as close to the front as we can. In this dimension, you are actually one of the furthest soldiers ahead right now, which is amazing. Okay, so we can move up again to this high cover with the Shinobi. Problem is, we would not see much through this alley, and there could be enemies that way, but they wouldn't see us either, so... Let's do it.
That's affirmative.
Let's keep looking for new enemies, and I can move again. Do I want to move again? Okay, so this direction is safe. Since we know that that direction is safe, what I can do is post up somebody here. Yeah, that's near the extent. So if we put you here, you'll see what's going on in this alley. What's going on in that alley? It's not an alley. It's an entire road. Whatever. Nothing. Okay. Then if there's nothing going on there right now, I don't mind having somebody move up to this rock where they could potentially be seen.
Got it covered.
I'll keep Enrique as far up as he can go. He's a little slow. He's just a little bit slow. Do we want Sergio there? I think we want the gunner there, in all honesty.
On the move.
I mean, we want Sergio up front, because we want him to be able to use his rocket launcher, but... Okay, tell you what. Ooh, you can go to here. Yeah, okay.
Already there.
Let's go there. Should be safe. I mean, you're a step or two ahead of the shinobi, but you're still concealed as well. So, it's fine.
10-4.
Alright, Deadwood, head to here. And Whiskey. What do we do with you? I guess we use here.
On the move.
No encounters yet, which is interesting. And we don't have to move ahead. We don't have to rush this. We've got two more train cars ahead. You don't need to be ahead of everybody else here. You're perfectly fine here. We still have concealment.
Orders confirmed. On the move.
We have to reveal something now, right? It's the next car ahead. All of the enemies in this map must be over here. I'll throw down extraction once we can see up here, and I'll put it like over here maybe if we're clear from this side, and we'll just hit this car and fuck it up. Alright, let's keep moving. I want you to be up here because you have to dash to do it. I might actually want you to be a little bit further ahead.
10-4.
Yeah. The shinobi is like the extent of where I want to be right now, so we will just put people in any position that's available up to there, and we shouldn't reveal anything. Actually, this might be dangerous because I'm going to move to here with you, and you will reveal a bit of fog in this direction. But no enemies, and you are concealed, so again, unless they were right here that you revealed, they would not have seen you. You would have just saw an enemy, you wouldn't have triggered them.
Rolling out.
This high cover probably would have been better used by the gunner now that I think about it. But I can just move the gunner back to here. It's not a big deal.
Eyes on the prize. Roger, I've got my eyes on.
And you... Only thing I'm skeptical about doing this is if there is a patrol come from the other direction, they will reveal us. So I think I'll put you back here. We don't have to go quickly, but I also don't want to be revealed. So let's just take it slow like that. Oh, okay. A trooper, a scout, and a turret. Fair enough. Who else can see that? Can you see them? No. Technically, you can't see them either. Who is giving me vision on that? It's got to be you, but you don't actually have shots on it, which is curious. Flounder, that's a dash to put you there? Wow, that's kind of irritating. Well then, I think I'm just going to dash anyway. There's no cover on the roof of these trains, unfortunately. I think we're just going to dash anyway to here then, and we'll use you next turn. So we're probably going to attack next turn at this rate.
We've got an enemy squad here.
Oh, there's another squad underneath too. What is it? There's a sectoid. This might be the same squad. Come on, give me control. There was a sectoid over here. I can't see it now. Scout, trooper, turret, and it looks like there might have been something inside, too. It's hard to see from here, though. Well, if there's no aliens over here, I could set up with, like, assault over here and maybe a ranger over here so that they can shoot in from this direction. I don't know where the sectoid was, and I don't know if it would walk out this way, but I could go there. Okay, shinobi... Oh, man, if they patrol downwards, they could reveal you. But we're going to engage next turn anyway, right? Like, one way or the other? Okay. Is this a no guts, no glory moment? Probably not, because those moments should not exist. Moments like that are stupid.
Double time.
Okay, assault, you're going to stay on this plane because I need you to be close enough and you just don't have the movement to do it otherwise. I'm going to actually put you up here too.
On the move.
Technical can go anywhere where he's going to get a rocket. No, no rocket. We've got the objective here. Technical, I'm going to put here.
Got it.
And we can move, so everything is well. Oh, well, you've got shots because we got vision, right. What's your range penalty? -4. So you're actually almost perfectly fine for range. It'll be interesting to put you up here, eh? Just take shots on them. Actually, that might not be bad. You'd have clear line of sight because of the elevation. The problem is, it's going to take a few turns to get you there. I mean, we've got concealment. We can do it. But it's a little awkward. You'd have such good shots on everything, though. Well, let's move you ahead to somewhere where next turn you're going to have a shot. And it should negate the range penalty. Sadly, it was a dash of one tile, so we can't steady weapon this turn, which is unfortunate. I would have liked to have steadied weapon. This is dangerous going here, because there is a sectoid up here. We know it's there. It could spot us. So I would like to keep directional cover. Problem is, there is no good directional cover that's going to give me shots out in that direction. So maybe we go here, and we overwatch, and he'll have to move in a future turn. He does have shots from here, actually, so that's perfectly fine. And yeah, I'm going to go all the way with you. You have a small detection radius. They'd have to go in a really awkward place to spot you. And I want eyes on that sectoid if I can get them. Sidewinder, sectoid, sectoid. Okay. Yeah. We want that sidewinder dead. So we might be shooting it with the sharpshooter. They are patrolling that way. Fuck. Okay, they went down, though. No reveal. Oh my god, they're going away, too. So, that just happened. The turret won't see the shinobi. I could potentially get the shinobi in there and do this hack without the turret ever seeing me. I would like to get the specialist in to do the hack, because I'd like a chance at whatever the goodies are from it, but... So if I reveal this turret and just, like, gib the turret completely, odds are both of those other squads will go onto yellow alert and will patrol into me. The Sidewinder will not trigger overwatch. Everything else should. Like, I can move you to here, for example, and just gib that. This is interesting. Or do we just try for total stealth, maybe? Like, the specialist can get pretty far. The specialist can be detected here, but I don't think he gets detected over here. He will be detected when he hacks it, one way or the other. We're gonna dash ahead to here. You know, now, given the circumstances, I think I am going to try and do something with you. We're only a couple turns away from getting into a position there. So let's do it.
Got it.
I am amazed. There's been like three of these missions where we've gone like full stealth mode all the way to the objective in them recently, and it's kind of crazy. Let's get closer this turn then. Okay. So this is saying you can just get there because it doesn't have vision until this tile out. So I will be extremely disappointed if we somehow get revealed on this move. I can see the turret. I know its vision range. I know that it's not supposed to know that I'm here. Yeah, there we go.
Heading to that location.
This is going interesting. We could without revealing ourselves run ahead all the way to here. Or get all the way in here. Wow. That's getting dangerous, because if this group does come up this way, it would be able to flank us. Like, would cover here flank us? Yes, cover here would flank us. Cover here wouldn't. Cover here would flank us. Cover here would flank us. I guess it'd be up to my quick, high damage, high risk, high reward people to protect me then, right? I'm gonna do it. I'm gonna put the gunner right in the thick of things. That means you could technically move closer, but I need you to move up, so no. This would reveal you, so we're not going to do that. We can't actually get there, though. Yeah, we're going to just move you ahead to the next high cover. Need you in an anchored position where you don't have to worry about much. Overwatch. Oh, what do we want to do with Shinobi? Shinobi-kun, you're going to go here.
Order's confirmed. Moving out.
Caleb Hall. Going to give us better vision on these guys. We can see the Sidewinder now. We can see the sectoids before. If it patrols back this way, I think we just fuck them up next turn and fuck up the turret next turn and say, hey, we still have 10 turns to get the hack that's 2 inches away from us.
Got it covered.
If it patrols the other way, though... Okay, scout, trooper, trooper. There's a mech. It's inside. I knew there was a mech. I knew I could hear something. Okay, so that Naja moved away. Who can shoot the mech? You can shoot the turret. You can shoot the mech, just the shinobi from this position. I don't have blue screen ammo or red screen or anything like that. I think there's red screen in this mod. You have shots on them from here. You get better shots from up on this high one, though. But you do reveal yourself by going in there like that. So what you need to do is move here.
Order's confirmed. On the move.
Open the gate. And now move, I guess, here. You're actually in a flanked position there. I don't want you in a flanked position. You're flanked by the turret, though, so nothing's going to see you. Yeah, you're flanked by the turret. It's not going to see you.
On my way.
I still want you to move here, though. And next turn, we get you up on the structure, and then the turn after that, we engage, I think. Yeah, I think we're going to do that. We're going to keep Shinobi here, or do we move the Shinobi in... We might move you in and put somebody else here who can get a better vision in through there and take advantage of it. I mean, Gunner can already see inside. Can you see the mech? No, you can see the two dudes. You can't see the mech. That's okay, though. Be good to have you somewhere where you're going to be able to shoot. So maybe where Whiskey is standing? No, Whiskey can't see because of this tree. Well, Gunner is in an exposed square, so Gunner can't move at all. So he's there. He's committed. He's locked in. He can't do anything else. This is low cover. This is high cover. I mean, you might be able to see something from up here at least, right? You won't reveal going into it. So let's do that. Apparently not. Shinobi will stay back here because I am worried if this guy patrols up this way and I'm in this position, they'll see us. If these guys come out and I'm in this position, they'll see me. So I think we just stay here. We've got lots of movement. We can get behind any of these guys. We can get all the way out to here and hit them with an axe attack, or a sword attack, rather. So I think you just stay there. I think you stay here with a bolt caster. You have a shot on turret, which is pretty good. Whiskey will stay here. Flounder stays there. Chop stays here and has run and gun range on a lot. There's going to be a lot of aliens on the other side of this train, though, so I am still worried about that. Yeah! Oh, you guys. Oh, shit. No. No, you guys. Fuck. They spotted us. By one tile. This pod has already moved, though, so it's just going to get a scamper. And we've got Overwatches galore. So this is basically an ambush anyway. Even though this isn't a real ambush, this is basically an ambush because we had Overwatches out the ass. The turret will get to shoot us, though. Maybe. Oh, they scampered into us. They moved into us. Oh, boy. Alright. So. We have two tiles of scatter. It would probably be four tiles because I have... I have fire in the hole. Well, I probably have four tiles of scatter if I moved, and I would really like to put a rocket on all of that shit. I'm just worried if I move to here that I might not have an effective rocket. We're gonna kill the mech, so... Yeah, go ahead, trust me. It's fine. Everybody should always trust me. So yeah, we've got four tiles of scatter. A good rocket here would be beautiful. Yeah, this could be gorgeous. It could be awful as well. But this could be gorgeous. It was literally useless. You piece of shit. You're still concealed. I mean, you should probably move to here and shoot the mech, right? I mean, we could combat protocol it and just kill it, but you should probably like just move to here and shoot the mech. You're gonna need to get up into position, which is not possible, so I guess you actually move up into here. Or you just shoot the turret this turn. Maybe you just shoot the turret this turn. Yeah. Fuck. I was hoping for a kill with you so that I wouldn't have to use anybody's actions out here to take out that turret. That's unfortunate. I like the Shinobi available for something else if possible. Maybe. Because you can flank any of these guys and be in high cover. Like that rocket, holy fuck. It felt bad. That rocket felt really bad, man. Really bad. I mean, you're not going to do much else. Do they have a rocketeer? Not that's revealed. I do need you to hack, but we've got 9 more turns for that. Okay, they weren't actually revealed anyway. Now if I rocketed them, it would have been better, I guess. Please don't pull me and just fucking gib my guys next turn. Thank you. Flashbang would have helped with that. We are flanked, though, which is great. Which is why I didn't want to commit anybody else's turns on this move. 85%. Let's just shoot. Let's not use combat protocol. And thank goodness we didn't have to regret it. Shinobi. You could kill the sectoid. You could kill the Sidewinder. If we could kill this sectoid with somebody else, then you'd be in pretty good shape. Let's put you here.
Sure thing.
You should have a flanking shot on the sectoid. You're also being flanked by the turret, but that's okay. Or maybe not. It might not have vision on you. Not sufficient. That's unfortunate. Yeah, technically you can do it. 9% currently. Would be a shame to move all the way up here and do that just to not really be effective. I think the turret's gonna be alive. So the turret can't see any of you. It can see you. And it can see you. It currently can't see you. So my question is, can the turret see us if we move to here? No. Nor can it see us if we go to here. Alright. We are going to go for the aggressive I want you all fucking dead this turn play. This won't result in them all being fucking dead this turn. But I'm hoping maybe there will only be a sectoid left. Maybe. So now the next safe move is to have the shinobi move to here and use a melee attack, which will reveal us, does 5 to 7, it has 6 health, we could kill it with this attack. Let's kill it with this attack then.
They're onto me.
We're spotted. 5. Fuck. I kinda needed a little bit more. If I had the better weapon, we would have been good. So that means that I am a little bit locked in on this. Well, no. I was gonna run and gun to here and try and kill the scout. But I might have to go for the Sidewinder instead now. You don't have Bladestorm, do you? No, I don't have Bladestorm on my my dudes yet. I think we do it anyway. Because you're going to be flanked one way or the other. Going here allows me to apply damage this turn. I'm going to have two people in exposed positions, and they're going to have to split between the two. And they both have vests on, I think. So I think you just go for the scout. 84 to crit. That's a kill. 8 damage.
You can't handle me.
Sectoid.
I've got eyes on that.
Another pod behind us. The sectoid will probably use a psi attack, might shoot.
Watch the flicks.
The Sidewinder will shoot or pull, or poison, maybe. Probably shoot, though. Miss? No, poison. Okay. Yeah, I'll take that. Sectoid moves to a position where he can't shoot, so he will use a Psy action. It'll be raise a Psy zombie. Probably behind this high cover, if I had to bet. Turret will shoot at you and miss. Good.
Need some help.
You're okay. You're alright. You're probably going to be poisoned for a little bit still. So I'm probably going to need you to finish it on this Sidewinder, even though you're poisoned. I'm sorry. I'm very sorry. But you've got probably the best chance of killing it. Well, you can guarantee kill it. Right? You can easily reach it with a grenade, and if you move back here outside of the poison cloud, you could still easily reach it with a grenade.
Absolutely.
So we're going to move out of poison so that you don't stay poisoned. You're going to throw a grenade. It'll kill the Sidewinder. It'll destroy the loot. Who gives a shit? 5 damage grenade from a non-grenadier without boosted cores. Like, seriously, guys? This would have been a good rocket as well if, you know, I still had a rocket. You're in a pretty good position against them. You're exposed. You need to get somewhere. So you go here. And do basically nothing else this turn. That's why I really wanted to kill the turret last turn, because I knew this turn was going to be a wash for you. I would love to know where the sectoid is exactly. Like, exactly what tile it's standing in. See, the problem is I don't have run and gun. I do have a grenade, but it's at full health. I'm not going to be able to get to it, right? I don't think so. I think you shoot this zombie and you guys hold them off. Like, how many tiles do I have to go before I see them? Here. So they have to move ahead to this tile in order to see you, basically. Alternatively, I can just move out to here, and they'd have to move even further ahead. Or I can just turn this corner and shoot the Psy zombie and hope I kill it. Okay, tell you what, let's go here. Hope we don't reveal a new pod. Oh, wow. The sectoid didn't go behind the cover. It's 8 health. I have to crit. And I have to get a good crit. Yeah, let's just do it. Please kill. Yes! That got the zombie. 2-for-1.
Who's keeping score?
And we didn't reveal another pod, which is really good. I was concerned that we would. Okay, we move you ahead to here, I think. And we put the gunner here. The gunner can get a guaranteed hit on something. We've got an exposed shot on the sentry, though. They have a rocketeer with 5 health. Okay, go here. Can you shoot the rocketeer? No. Let's save your hail of bullets for a second. I'm going to put you up here. See, the thing is, you can throw a grenade. It could kill the sentry, it probably won't kill anything else, but it could put us in a position where a hail of bullets could kill something else. Like, I could kill the sentry here. Hail of bullets is not for sure guaranteed to kill the gunner or the officer right now. But if we threw a grenade with you and targeted, well, I guess these two, we have a chance of just killing the sentry. And we could do enough damage to the officer that a hail of bullets would kill it.
Fire in the hole!
Okay, so we don't just kill the sentry. Fair enough, it's okay. Wasn't expecting to get a kill there. This is still high cover, which means a flamethrower will probably be ineffective, but you also have a frag grenade. Let's take a look at the flamethrower real quick, though. Actually, you know what? The flamethrower would be effective on both of them. So we're not even going to use a frag grenade. We are going to flamethrower both of these guys. We can't hit the guy behind. It's okay.
Multiple targets neutralized.
We destroy the loot. Whoop-de-fucking-do. Do we hail of bullets him? We can do 5 to 7. Actually, yeah, we do, because we have center mass, right? Yeah, so it's minimum damage is 5 with center mass. We absolutely hail the bullets. The Rocketeer could hurt us a bit. But we kill somebody. The turret can only see our specialist, who has 73 on the turret. Do we shoot the turret? We're in low cover to it. I'd like to be in high cover to it if I don't kill it. So let's move to here. I could, you know, guarantee this kill by using combat protocol. Let's just shoot it. 79. Yep, that's sufficient.
You can't handle me.
You can't handle me. Apparently not. And that's our turn. Rocketeer runs and blows himself up. No, he shoots. And he misses hard. Okay. I just want to... yeah, right. Poison. I just want to point one thing out to you, Mr. Rocketeer. You don't get into a shot trading battle with a ranger who has, like, ridiculous aim-ups. I could probably just take two shots at you with Enrique here and most likely kill you this turn. And we'd probably be fine. Honestly, with you that far back, that's the best move I have, too. So let's just do it. Told ya.
By the numbers.
Like, I told you.
Oh, yeah.
So we're gonna call for an evac. We'll put it right here, I guess. Stop being so dramatic. It's not an emergency evac, it's our standard evac. And you had an autoloader, actually. So you can overwatch this turn, too. I understand you're still poisoned. Go pick up this loot for me, please. Laser sight. Acceptable. Get into cover. Yeah, we're not med-kitting that off of you right now, sorry. You can go without stepping in this poison and pick up this loot for me, please.
Let's do this.
What is it? Illyrium core. Yes. Please.
So here it is.
And move to here. Don't go through the poison, please. We don't have a reinforcement wave yet, which is awesome. I'd like to keep it that way if possible. Do you have vision on it from here? No. Okay, so we do have to go inside. Alright, let's just go ahead. And we'll hack it next turn. And we'll probably get reinforcement soon too, right? Like, high likelihood. We can go ahead to here. No, we'll stay here. And we'll start steadying weapon. Let's reload first, though, because we can for a single action, non-turn ending. And then let's steady weapon. And you're in an okay spot. I'm going to put you here, just in case. I don't know where they're going to come from. And we're going to reload. I know the reinforcements can't drop next turn because we don't have a warning up, so we'll reload this turn. We're not going to get out next turn.
If you say so.
So I'm going to move you without reloading your bolt caster to where, without lighting yourself on fire, you can get this loot on the next turn.
All right, that one hurt.
Reinforcements? No reinforcements yet. Okay. Let's start by grabbing this because I want it.
What's
and watch, reveal another pod in the process. PCS conditioning. Okay. That's good.
Where to?
I'll definitely take conditioning. And now move ahead to this.
Okay, I'll go.
This train is on fire. Like, the armor plating is burning. Let me just tell you, when armor plating burns, you've got bigger problems than just fire. Like, you've got all kinds of vaporifics issue. Like, all kinds of toxic gas. Alloy cache, that's good. What's a watch list? What is a watch list? Reduce contact costs for a nearby region. That's pretty good. 60% for alloys. I'll go for that. Come on. Yeah, we got it. Looks like that roll would have gotten us the watch list too. And success. We rolled like a 90 something on that one. Hack the planet. Wow, you are... You are just lame. So there is another pod in this mission. It's pretty out there, it looks like. But hacking this triggered it.
Let's do this.
So it will be coming to us at a good clip. Let's get in position to fuck him up, I think. You're going to stay back here and hunker... No, you will overwatch. You're going to steady weapon again. You don't have long watch, so there's no point doing anything else. You'll overwatch. And now you can overwatch from this position. I know they're coming from there. Over here probably would be better. I'm going to move you to here and overwatch. And then next turn you can move somewhere else, maybe. And I'm going to reload you. We're going to go up into high cover. A little closer to the direction that I know they're coming from and reload. So if reinforcements trigger next turn, then they'll drop on the following turn, which is the same turn the evac is here. So reinforcements will do nothing. Can you reach evac? You can. I'm going to move you ahead to here, though. You're still poisoned. Maybe we should have medkitted you. Okay. Tell you what. Because I'm feeling generous, I'm going to medkit you. Just to reduce the amount of wounded time you're going to have. Because one more HP would wound you for even longer.
Moving to overwatch.
You're in range? Yeah, everybody's in range. But you have no ammo, so you have to reload. Okay, there we go. Are you in range? That's a good question. Yeah, you should be. I'm going to move you ahead to here, though, this turn. Because I absolutely do not want to fuck this up. I want out on the next turn.
Overwatch.
You hacked, so I never reloaded you last turn.
Moving to overwatch.
Affirmative, covering now.
And do they see
Enemy
me? They're running. They are running on the map trying to get to me.
This is Firebrand. It's time to go.
There is an unannounced reinforcement. Oh no. This is the announcement of reinforcements. There's reinforcements warping in next turn. That's okay.
Absolutely.
Go ahead. Reinforcements warp in.
I guess that'll be okay.
Are you you're not disoriented. Why are you like, I guess that'll be okay? Doesn't make any sense at all.
Tired of waiting around.
Yeah, that pessimistic attitude is awesome.
On my way.
Let's get the hell out of here. I mean, we had a lot of people on this mission. It was a high priority mission.
Tired of waiting around.
We brought 7 dudes.
Get out of here.
But I think we went the right way. I think by going up this side of the train, we managed to get all the way to the objective before engaging. And that's awesome. Get all the way to the objective before engaging. Don't kill all the aliens on the map. That's Long War 2. You don't get experience for killing aliens. Well, you do, but it's very little. You get it for completing missions. And with one wound, and the wound came from poison. I could have actually prevented that wound entirely if I just cured the poison earlier. 100% shot percentage? Yeah, okay. Wow. I'll see you back on the Avenger. Here we go, boys. Here we go.
Squad made it back full, and the aliens paid the price.
That's 4 promotions. Nice. And we're only wounded for 8 days, which isn't bad. 4 promotions, 1 new call sign. So, Rodriguez, what's your call sign, sir? Sergio Rodriguez is Deacon. We have DEFCON and Deacon now. You're going to take biggest booms. Gives you a chance for crits on your rockets and grenades. Chops. That gets you Killer Instinct, right? Yep, that's good. Next tier has some interesting choices, but Tech Sergeant is where we get rapid fire. This is where you can really start to put out shit tons of damage. Or hit and run or close encounters. I'll decide. Probably going to be rapid fire, but we'll see. Killer Instincts. Yes, please. Plus 50% crit damage. That's also going to put your shotgun competitive with laser weapons if you don't get a laser shotgun. As long as you're getting crits. Deadwood. Okay. Dead Watch, 10% chance to crit enemies. Phantom, you stay concealed, which can be good. Long Watch, overwatch to trigger with squad sight. So the thing is, I want to be using stock to get steady aim on turns. So I don't know if I would ever be using Long Watch. So I think we actually go Deadshot. So we're basically the Marksman Snapshot Sniper, except without the snapshot. Yeah, I think we just take Deadshot. Long Watch could be the correct play here, but I don't know. I feel like we would need Death from Above so that we can counter that long distance penalty a little bit in order to use that effectively. And specialists, we can get Field Medic. Equipped medkits have 2 extra charges. This is not medical protocol, so the gremlin doesn't perform healing actions. We still have to do it ourselves. But you get extra medkit uses. Suppression, which I don't feel like I want to take. Or airdrop, which gives us an extra grenade to a targeted ally. Airdrop is pretty cool. I think we take Field Medic. Next tier, we're probably taking Failsafe, but Field Surgeon is really good as well. And that's it. Oh, no, there's one more person. No promotion, though. Flounder was not promoted. 1 Illyrium Core, 1 Laser Sight, 1 PCS Conditioning plus 1, 1 Hair Trigger, 1 Expanded Magazine. I would really like some high-tier Expanded Magazines. If I get a bunch of low-tier ones, I might just do the Foundry Project on it so that I can make more. I don't know what you get from the Foundry Project, though, because that is a Long War 2 edition. 10 alloys. Okay. That was from that hack cache. That's good. I like to see that. And I think that's going to be the end of this video, guys. I'll see you next time. I might try a new encoding technique next time and see if it makes things easier on me, less processing time and all that shit. But I'm not sold on it yet. I might experiment some more. I'll see you later.